It's interesting, I've never had a 9-to-5 job. You know, I'm the only one in my family that has not had a 9-to-5 job, for better or worse. It's interesting, I chose filmmaking, and it's something I've always done. I have two younger brothers, where we started making these homemade videos, and we just continued to do that. And my parents were incredibly supportive. This is the first time I've used the form factor of the PYXIS, and the compact size allowed us to be able to do rigging in ways that we couldn't do before. An example of that would be rigging the PYXIS to the back end of the motorcycle. And doing something like that with a larger camera wasn't easily feasible. And so this compact size allowed us to do that in a very, very minimal way. We had the bike and we had the tilted hydro arm and the camera. There are certain moves that I've always wanted to do but weren't possible given the form factor of a standard size drone. So mounting it to an FPV drone allowed us to basically have that high sense of speed and dynamic and kinetic action. And the sensor combined with the size allowed us to do things such as go under the bridge or with our amazing drone pilot, Ilya, go through this wooden forest and we just basically slot it through that. Rolling shutter performance all that was excellent, and it was excellent to be able to do it in 8K, both 2.4 and 3.2. I love street photography, I love documentaries, and I love to be able to capture those moments where you're like, this is that person and this is their story in this moment in time. I love shooting wide open because I think it forces our perceptions. The mountain shot was at Mount Rainier. I chose it because it shows off what the sensor is capable of, being able to capture vast landscapes in a natural environment with no lighting and gear support, along with minimal crew. The camera allowed us to be able to capture that authentic moment in a location I think that's very, very well known to people in Washington. Wait, did they just put a camera, a cinema camera, in the back of a motorcycle and just drive it around? It's like, yes, we did. We really did, you know? And then, did you really put it on an FPV drone? Yes. Did you run it through, like, this very, very small window? Yes, we did, like, 7 times. Right, you have these incredible sensors and you have this whole workflow. You now have authorship of the imagery. What you shoot and what you don't shoot are both indicative of who you are.